James Wine, The First Wine Is Next, con il producer Castello di Fontorotoli, Vico Reggio 36, Chianti Classico, Gran Selezione, 2017 Vintage, stay tuned, and I'll give you my thoughts on this beautiful outstanding wine. So excited about this wine, and so I was on a tasting with one of the Matsai family members, and that is Giovanni Matsai. Now, they've owned this estate since about 1435, 26 generations of the Matsai family holding on to this estate, producing gorgeous wines. And so I think, to me, you know, Chianti Classico is just, you know, Chianti Classico Gran Selezione is a joy in the glass. And it's so superbly crafted, beautiful, gorgeous. Every single producer with a Gran Selezione is different from every other producer. And I think this shows a great fineness to it. Vico Reggio 36, 36 means 36 different biotypes. That is, think about all the different types of Sangiovese that are planted on the estate. So the idea was to input all 36 unique biotypes into one wine itself. So getting to this core, there's fundamentally Chianti Classico Gran Selezione. So the site is 350 meters above sea level, which is about 1400 feet. And so this is a clay-rich limestone, abundant in fossil matter, 13.5% ABV. So all 36 biotypes are hand-harvested. Vinification is then fermented in French oak barrels, 500 liter, 78 to 82 degrees Fahrenheit, grape maceration for 20 days. So the wine is aged in 18 months in French oak, 500 liter format, 50% of this is new, then a concrete tank for finessing for 4 months prior to bottling. This is a $99 suggested retail price point. And so I'm just a fan of this producer to begin with. But secondly, because of this input, and I'm very clonal and biotype and ecotype and every kind of specific variation that you find on Vitis vinifera, that is a wine grape. And I think this really comes out to being a very polished wine, something that's very, very sophisticated. So some impressions are on this wine: tart red cherry notes, cedar sandalwood, moist red soil, autumnal leaves, spice, and red rose petal. Outstanding. And next, the palate characterization. For me, when I taste that acidity, I'm tasting things that this is gonna go handsomely with cheese, charcuterie, salmon. I'm thinking of bistecca fiorentina. So what you want to do with a nice fine wine like this, obviously, is enjoy with food, but do yourself a favor, taste a little bit beforehand before you serve with food, because I really want you to taste the fineness of this wine. And so I think, to me, it just really is expressive and beautiful, and acidity is telling me that this is going to last quite some time. Imagine this 10 years from now. It's an outstanding bottle of wine right now. It's going to get even better, in my opinion, in the future. So on this, tart red cherry notes, a hint of pomegranate, red tea, dried bay leaves, and a hint of spice on the finish. Absolutely glorious, 95 points out of 100 points. So the core on this is elongated. It just goes on mid-palate to the finish. And it's something that's just so luxuriant and beautiful. And that's what I look up to and look forward to tasting Chianti Classico Gran Selezione. I'll put more information on the producer down below. Ask your wine merchant to bring in this wine. It's a special wine, save for U.S. Thanksgiving. Enjoy this for, you know, a very special meal year-round. For me, I get some beautiful autumnal characterization that really sings to me of praises of enjoying some beautiful autumnal meals Thanksgiving. Doesn't have to be a Thanksgiving, but it can be any time of the year. And to me, it's just so lyrically beautiful, expressive, and gorgeous. So thank you for watching. Let's stay connected. You'll find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, and WordPress. Additionally, you'll find me on my podcast, Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, Spotify, and iHeartRadio. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon. Salute.